about your journey and your son's journey with cystic fibrosis?
Well, my son Chris will be 46 in September, and he was he lives in Toronto now, but he was born and raised in Saskatoon, and he was diagnosed with cystic fibrosis at age 2.5. He had a lot of digestive problems and failure to thrive. It took a while to make the diagnosis, and he went through his teenage years pretty well. When he was diagnosed, he wasn't expected to reach adulthood, but now, Dr. Tam had said the life expectancy, life expectancy is over 50, so he's kind of just been on the edge all these years. But about 3 years ago, he became very ill. He had a dramatic fall in his lung functions. They were down to 27%, at which point you look at lung transplant. But amazingly, his doctor in Toronto, Dr. Tullis, identified he was a G551D gene. And there was a new drug just past clinical trials called Kalydeco, and it worked on the basic defect for that particular genetic mutation. So the drug was not available in Canada, but access was made available on compassionate grounds. And he started a pill twice a day. Within weeks, he started to improve. And now, 3 years later, his lung functions are over 60%. So he's been, we've been very fortunate that he was the right genetic. The drug was available to him at the right time. And I mean, just over the course of Chris's life, we've seen just so many advances in therapy, and it's just amazing. Like Cystic Fibrosis Canada was begun 55 years ago, and in that time, phenomenal advances have been made, and we've been fortunate to benefit. So we're still not there, we're close. With the genetic discovery of genetics and this new drug, they're doing more clinical studies for more common genetic types. The kind Chris has is there's only about 110 people in Canada with that specific genetics, and they're hoping to have other combination drugs that basically it reverses the basic defect. So, and now like there's newborn screening so that babies are diagnosed at birth can start treatment earlier. So there's lots of good things happening.
As a parent, I'm wondering, when you hear that diagnosis, he's not supposed to, expected to live past adulthood, and then he keeps exceeding it and exceeding it. It does it get any better? Do you get less scared, or is it just still as scary knowing that mortality is maybe around the 50 mark?
Yeah, well, I guess, well, my son is the most optimistic person and lives on hope and optimistic, so that carries us too. And day to day, things are going well. You kind of put it aside and you live life, whatever life you have, to the fullest. But when there's an event happened like 3 years ago, or even now, if I hear he's got a cold, I might, you do worry. But the thing is that to make the most of life, and my son is a career, and he's lived a very normal life in spite of the CF.
Do you have any other children?
I have two others, another son and a daughter.
And do they have cystic fibrosis?
No, they don't.
I'm wondering, what is your reaction to Dr. Julian now being hired specifically to work with adults with cystic fibrosis?
Yeah.
What's your reaction to that?
Just thrilled, and to all the CF community too, especially for the adults, to have his expertise and the extra leadership too for the clinic. Because there's a large number that need to be seen frequently and keep them as well as possible for that cure that is just around the corner.
Excellent. I'll grab your first and last name and how to spell them both, just for our records. Mm-hmm. So go ahead. How do you spell your first name?
J-O-A-N, Joan, and Lidington, L-I-D-I-N-G-T-O-N.